Hello student, good morning. So today we are going to learn from 3 Science Chapter 6 about magnetism. So previously we already learned until here about generating electric. A brief introduction how to make electric is by Okay, first thing first, in this topic, we need to know how to make electric. Okay, this one, this picture I already draw. This is the magnetic field. Okay, this is the magnetic field that I draw. Of course, the picture is not nice now. You need to find in your textbook, you can see a better picture. So it's something like this. This is a magnet. This is north. This is south. Utara, selatan. So the magnetic field will here go like that. Something like that lah ha. Of course, if you find the book, it will look nicer than my drawing. Okay, something like that. Then here got a few more line. Here got a few more line. So every magnet got a magnetic field. How to know the magnetic field? You can use Tesla. You can use either magnet to test, or you use the metal powder experiment. I don't know whether you got do before or not. Means you take the metal powder, like the serbuk besi, and you pour on the magnet, and then you shake, and then you will see in your plate lah, something like this. Okay, something like this. The magnetic field of the magnet. Yeah, so you can make a magnetic field by cutting the magnetic field. How to cut the magnetic field? Not use your knife to cut the magnetic field. How to cut the magnetic field? You can see that here already teach last week. In order to make electric, what you need to do is cut the magnetic field. Magnetic field line to be cut. Magnetic field line to be cut. In order to make electric, we want to cut the magnetic field. How to cut the magnetic field? We use the wire, movement of the wire or movement of the magnet. It's the same thing lah. Either you move the magnet or you move the wire. So let's say here is the wire. If I put the wire here, should put it here, I think. Put the wire lah. How to? Okay, for example, I put the wire here. Imagine this line is the wire. So each time I take the wire, soup like that, I got electric in the wire. But very little lah, because you just, your hand only do one time, and you also don't know because the electric is so little that you cannot detect. So either you take the wire, metal rod or wire, do like that, then your hand there got electric, but you don't feel it because it's too little. Or you don't want to use the magnet, you want to move the wire, you move the magnet. Let's say this is the magnet lah. So I move the magnet. So now I produce electric in this wire. Either you move the magnet or you move the wire. So in this experiment, we can see that you can move the wire or move the magnet, also you generate electric. But the electric is not strong. How to make it strong? Very easy. Either I make a lot of wire. One wire, two wire, three wire, four wire, to make the electric more electric. So that's why we can see here is called solenoid. Means they take this magnet, they put all the wire, a lot of wire, then I move the magnet or move the wire. So if a lot of wire is crossing the magnetic field, so this one will produce more electric. So we can see that here they are using the solenoid to increase the electricity. So whether you want to increase the solenoid or you want to increase move or magnet, is still the same. Okay, the magnetic field of the magnet is being cut, so you got the electric. Of course, then you can see the galvanometer deflect, showing that there is current in the experiment. So the government meter will go front, go back, go front, go back, because you go in front, go in back, go in front, go in back. So your current will go front, go back, go front, go back. And then we look at this experiment. The book didn't mention properly, but this one is just how to say very brief introduction of the magnet. So this is called the simple generator to cause electric. Okay, so in this experiment, you need to turn the thing in order to make electric. So of course, this experiment, after you do, you put, you turn, then got electric. Very simple, but actually it's not that simple. Now I know lah. Exam, I think they won't ask lah. But anyway, we just look at this. Why I say it's not that simple? Because we can see that this is the wire. You can see the wire. So there's north and south. When every time you turn, the magnetic field is cut, because the wire will go up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. So the wire will, it will produce current. So what is happening here is, it will something like, every time you go up, down, up, down, up, down, actually the current is going to the front, then behind, front, then behind, front, then behind. It doesn't work because the current just go in front, behind. So it will go like produce electron to the current to the front, produce electron to the back, produce current to the front, produce current to the... So it doesn't work. So what they do is they add this thing called the carbon brush. So they cut the carbon brush to half. In order, I don't want to make the current go in front, then back, go in front, then back. I put the carbon brush. So every time the carbon brush turn, it will change where the electric go. So every time it almost go behind, the carbon brush will touch another side, it will still go to the front. So every time you turn this thing, the electric also will produce properly. So it's a direct current, means the current just go in front. Okay, so very difficult to teach in video because I cannot show you how this thing turn and how this thing turn. But if you at school, you can see the teacher turn the thing and experiment is good. Simple to say is, this thing is to cross the magnetic field. This thing also can turn so that the electric will not go front, go back. It will just go front. Before it go back, it will change again the direction. Go front, go front, go front, go front. Then you will have your LED light showing that electric is being produced. Observation, LED, stationary and rotating. What is the observation? So in this experiment, we can see that if the thing is stationed, means it's not moving, then it don't have light because you don't turn mah. No turn means there is no cutting of magnetic field. No cutting of magnetic field means there is no electric. But when I rotate the thing, we got magnet here, so the wire will cross the magnetic field. It will produce current. So how to increase the current? So maybe if you want to increase the current, maybe we can say we rotate faster. Because if you rotate faster means also cutting the magnetic field faster. Okay, because you move fast mah. Like you in a bicycle, you cycle fast, then the light is more brighter as you compare to you move slowly. Or maybe I can say use a stronger magnet. You want to use a stronger magnet, then you got more electric field because the magnetic field is stronger. Or some more got what? Or just now we already say that for example, we can increase the coil. Increase the coil. The coil means I'm talking about the wire lah, huh? The coil means the wire. Means I put more wire. If more wire means more electric. So of course we want more electric, right? Nobody want less electric, because again, why we want to do this thing? This thing can make money, correct or not? Because you know every month how much your parent pay for TNB? A lot, right? 100, 200, 300. And if can you imagine the whole Malaysia pay money to TNB, and how much money that you can earn by just making electric. Now electric still being monopoly lah, but I think there are some now TNB is doing the solar so that at home can produce electric. Like Japan lah, they got a solar panel. Now also TNB is doing that business. So I don't know, it's a good business opportunity. Maybe one day you need to think how to make electric so that you can sell to people and you get money. Correct or not? Everyone like money. I like money. Question one. Mark the true statement of the cutting of the magnetic field. A. When the coil of the wire and magnet are stationed, the magnetic field line are cut. Station, you need to understand, stationary is not the pencil. Stationary means it's station, not moving. LRT station. Correct or not? Because the station is not moving, the train is moving. So station means not moving. Bus station. The bus station cannot move on, it's stationed at there, stop at there. So that's why it's called bus station. Bus stop. Oh, that's the better word. Station also means stop. Okay? So when the wire and the magnet didn't move, the magnetic field line are cut. Let me read again. When the coil of wire and magnet are stationed, the magnetic field line are cut. So this one is wrong lah. Correct or not? Because the magnetic field no cut mah. Because you also didn't move. So of course no cut. Okay. When the coil of the wire move inside the stationary object, the magnetic field are cut. So now we are saying that it move. So when the coil of the wire move, the magnetic field are cut, correct lor? Because you move mah, you move the coil and the magnet to cut the magnetic field. So put a tick here. Current will only be induced when the magnetic field line is being cut. So the answer is correct. Current mah will only be induced electric lah. Let's say I don't want to use current, I use electric. Where's my thing? Let's say I don't want to use I say electric will only be induced. So electric will only be induced. I just change the word induced to produce lah. Produce means give rise to, means make something come out. Electric will only be produced when magnetic field line are cut. Yes, if you want to make electric, that's why we want to say cut the magnetic field. Okay, why they don't want to use electric? What is the difference between electric and current? What is the difference between electric and current? Why don't just say electric easy lah? Why you want to say current? Okay, so one thing we need to know in electric, how to measure electric? The formula is volt times, where's my X? Volt times ampere equivalent to watt. Okay, so this is the formula for to get electric, because if you TNB come to your house, they want to charge you money, they need to know how much you use. So there is a formula to count the electric, the watt, then times the time, how much time that you use. So electric is more special. There are two, you need to time these two things. As I mentioned, if you want to measure how long the thing, we just use meter, or we use how hot, we use Celsius. 100 Celsius is boiling point, 0 Celsius is freezing point. Electric is a bit different. They need to use watt time ampere, because as I say, ampere means how fast the electric will go, because some electric go faster, some electric go slower. Watt is how much energy it want to carry. So of course watt increase, ampere increase the best lah, huh? So you got very fast moving and many energy that is being carried. But so I hope you understand, but if you don't understand, so never mind. But just learn for fun lah, huh? So that's why they say current, because it's talking about the moving, the movement, and how fast the electric can go. Being produced in the magnetic field. How is induced current detected in this activity? How you want to know there is a current in this activity? How to detect the, how the current detect, okay, by the LED. LED light. Okay, we detect by LED light. Means got light, there's a current. No light, no current. Brighter light, more current. Lesser light, less current. Very good. How is induced current produced by the DC generator? So of course, by moving the axle, the coil of the wire will cut the magnetic field. When the magnetic field line is cut, it will produce electric. So very long line, I don't want to type lah, huh? But how the he asked me how the current produced. First you need to move the axle lah, then you explain a bit. Okay, the axle need to move so that the coil will cut the magnetic field. When the coil cut the magnetic field, current will be induced, or you can say electric will be produced. But since the question asks, always use the word current and induced, I just use current and induced lah. The current will be induced, like more professional a bit lah, huh? Okay, state two form of energy other than electric energy being produced in this activity. What two form of energy that is being produced? Very good. So two form energy that's being produced is the heat and light. So just say light and heat lah. Light and heat. Because after you move this thing, it will produce what? After you move this thing from kinetic energy, it will become electric energy, correct or not? Because you move the thing mah. After become electric energy, it will become light energy. And if got light means got heat, then become heat energy. Of course it will go on and on lah, okay? After heat energy will go to kinetic energy lor, because the air got heat and it will cut out while it break. So very good. State two advantages of LED as a lighting device compared to a filament bulb. Okay, state two advantages of a lighting device compared to filament. Two advantages of LED light. So of course there are a lot of advantages for LED. So one thing that we can say, it is more low power consumption. Okay, LED light has a lower electric consumption. A And for number two, we can say that it has a higher lifetime. So that's why when we go and buy light nowadays, my house light. Now this up my house I use LED. I changed already. Last time I used to be filament. Now I use LED light because if you use the old light, my house light, the when you turn on the line, the light will be zzzzzzzzzz, then the light will come out. But now LED light, you just turn on, poop, got light already. No need to wait. And of course, it is lesser light consumption, lesser use of energy, and more difficult to die. Okay, higher lifetime, more LED light is more, the lifespan of a LED light is higher, but the downside is it's more expensive. So we need to count whether you want to use old light or new light, but old light will use more electric, new light will use less electric, but new light will be more expensive. Old light will be cheaper, but just use LED light. Now new technology or people use LED light because you save also save like 20-30 cents. Just keep it. One light cost LED light now is like 15 ringgit, 13 or 15 ringgit. So just never mind lah, few ringgit give him lah. Okay, so we look at this electric generate power station. Again, why we want to generate electric? Because we want to earn money, correct or not? You know, earn money. And in Malaysia, most of the energy, the number one energy we use is actually we are using the fuel, diesel and natural gas and not hydroelectric. I think it's more than 50%, I forgot already. More than 50%, Malaysia is using electric by using fuel rather than hydroelectric. So, using electric actually cause pollution, cause increase of carbon dioxide, increase of heat on the earth and so on. Because since Malaysia are using, I think around 50 or 60% fuel, each time you turn on the light, it use a lot of fire. Fuel, you need to use fire to burn ma. So actually it can cause pollution when we use electric at home. So the wonder the earth is getting worse lah, huh? Because every time we turn on the light, we are causing pollution. The increase of carbon dioxide, I wouldn't say pollution, but the increase of carbon dioxide which can cause global warming. Okay, so how to make this thing? It's the same thing. You want to cut the magnetic field, but only the magnet is bigger, and the wire to cut the magnetic field is a lot bigger. So what they do is they put the field, and the water become hot. So the water when become hot, it will become gas. When the water become hot and become gas, it will create high pressure, correct or not? Like when you cooking that time, cook the water, you turn on the fire, then the pot will all the wind come out. You try to close, see can bao zha or not? I don't know lah, maybe can bao zha. You try to do that, close everything, and you boil it, see whether the thing will bao zha or not. But you know it will bao zha one, but we got a hole, so that when the water boil, then the steam, because you know how much pressure it can create. So you burn it, if you put the steam will turn the turbine because it's got the high pressure. So it will blow to push the turbine. Of course, the turbine will turn like a dynamo. And it will generate electric to your house. After turn, this thing will go to condenser. Oh, that's why they use seawater. Because the reason if you use seawater, you are saving your energy. You want to cool the steam down. you want to cool it down mah, because hot mah. So if you want to cool down, you want to use ice, you are using energy again. So you use seawater, you do beside the sea lah. You don't do the river lah. Huh? You do the river, I scared all the fish will die. So we just use the seawater to cool down the gas. So when we cool down the gas, it will become water. And the water will become the, go to the boiler and become the steam again. And the process will continue to make electric. But actually all the thing is the same lah, the turbine. This is also being used in the train. Last time train, correct or not? Last time steam train. Yeah, actually from steam train first, how the technology developed or steam engine. After there has a steam train, then it start to develop to a steam ship. Last time no engine mah. So the first engine they create is for car. Of course it's failed because the car is so big, and why you want to use a car that's so big to travel so little, and you need to put the coal behind, some people put, you know, burn it, you know, so mafan. And yes, it go very very slow. But now very high tech, they change until you use it at the train, so the train can move by using a steam engine. Instead of making electric, you just make the thing turn lah. Huh? This thing turn is actually the engine, okay? Make it turn. And then we use it for the steam engine, like Titanic lah. Huh? You go Titanic, then you got steam engine. After got steam engine, what happened? After got steam engine is Malaysia being conquered lah, huh? By the British. Because last time British don't have fish, don't have ship mah. So the British cannot use the sampan to tanam layu. After the steam engine, you can see that they come until Malaysia and they conquer Malaysia, and after that got Japan lah, blah 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 blah, so on. So this is the mechanism. Burning of fuel produce the steam, and then turn that produce the electric energy, and then energy from the chemical energy, because it's the fuel, to the heat energy, the fire, then to the kinetic energy, because this thing turn, and then to the electric energy, which is this thing like electric energy. Power station. Okay, I don't want to explain too much. I think you guys understand lah. Huh? Use the sun and it will produce electric energy. That actually is not easy, you know. This whole thing can be one chapter, and actually I also forgot already how this thing works. Last time I got read before, I forgot already. Okay, how the light energy become the electric energy. Hydroelectric station is the same thing. As long as you make this thing turn, you can use something to cut the magnetic field and you still will produce electric. This thing also the same. Turn this thing, you got the wind, then you can produce electric. But of course, Malaysia use this one lah. Malaysia also use hydroelectric. Malaysia seldom use this one, because Malaysia got a lot of mountain. If I'm not mistaken, now Malaysia got a lot of mountain. You see, from here go to your house also, don't know how many mountain I need to cross. But if you see other country, like, I don't know, like Texas or what, you look, there's no mountain one, 平的, the whole land is straight. That's why they have tornado. Why Malaysia don't have tornado? Because we got a lot of mountain. Eh. The mountain will actually block the wind. Block the wind, create rain, do a lot of things lah, huh? But you very almost impossible to make tornado. This one is what Malaysia is trying to do. I think maybe next 5 years or 10 years, Malaysia will manage to produce the nuclear fuel, which is still the same thing. Instead of using the fuel to make the thing hot, we just use the uranium. The nuclear to, because the bomb can make fire mah. So it's still the same, it make it hot and it will still produce the beam, steam, and it will move the generator. So a lot of people say not good because they get explode. Yes lah, if you don't careful, this thing explode, then a lot of people will die. But I depend on you lah. I know a lot of people don't support, but I still support lah, because make sure it don't explode lah, huh? Make sure it don't explode, and do this thing far away from the resident area. Even Malaysia is doing this far, you know. They don't do this in the housing area. So in case this thing explode, no people is going to die, or die also the people inside there die. So then make it far far away in the mountain to do this nuclear reactor. Why I suggest to do this? Because you want to get money from the little thing that you get, plutonium or uranium, maybe just one stone, but the one stone can produce energy for the whole city, like the nuclear bomb lah, just like one stone, but it can produce energy to the whole Kuala Lumpur, for example. The rock lah, huh? The nuclear, everything. So, yep. But now it's very high tech, you know. Bill Gates do one lah. Bill Gates say won't explode one. He say don't know what new technology. Even you, the reason it explode because the rod control the nuclear unstable or what, so it explode. So Bill Gates do a new one that say that the don't have electric also won't explode one. It's a new technology. But of course we are like not the first world country lah. We are the second country, and my friend say going to become the third world country, you know, but so never mind lah, we just use the old technology. Biomass, okay, also the same. You put all the dirty thing, the cow tai, the pokok tai, all the whatever tai lah, yeah, you want to put in. That animal, that's you just put in, and then it will become the gas, methane gas. You burn it, then it turn the turbine, and it will produce electric. How we get fuel from the dinosaur? Dinosaur die already, way after like a very long time with a high pressure. Then you can get fuel or get the gas. Same with me and you die. One day me and you die, if we wait for very long, we also will become the petrol. Then our children will use us to drive the car. The bone all become gone, the head, the hair, everything become gone, become petrol. But must meet a certain condition with the pressure, especially with the pressure. So it's the same thing, you want to make it faster. You don't put the dead thing into the tanah, the soil. You just put it in the container with a higher pressure a bit, so we can speed up the process. But this one we will not learn this, but this thing with a high pressure a bit, they can speed up the process. So they can make it to become a gas, burn it, the boiler, and it will become the steam to produce electric. Ah, which country use this? I forgot already. Korea, Taiwan, something like that. It's very nice, eh? They use all the rubbish, they burn all the rubbish. Eventually, or they put all the rubbish into the floor. We eventually produce biomass to generate back electric to the city. So, forget lah, Taiwan, Korea. It's very smart, lah. You throw all the rubbish, they collect all the rubbish, put it in the biomass, and because you eat the thing, eat the fish or the chicken, or you don't want, you throw, and you will produce back electric. So you don't waste. So for the metal, you recycle the metal. For the glass, you recycle the glass. For the paper, you recycle the paper. For the food that you eat, you can recycle it to produce electric, to make methane gas. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoy it, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you and bye bye.